Today we travel down to Marshall Tufflex to see how plastic conduit's been made, but why are you holding a window?
Because interestingly, white plastic conduit is mostly made from recycled windows. So we're going to go inside, we're going to meet Darren Blake, the manufacturing manager, and see how it's done.
Now that doesn't look like a plastic window to me.
Believe it or not, this was once a PVC U windows that's been crushed down into a format that we can use in our compounding process.
And you're going to turn that into plastic conduit. Is there anything in there that needs to be removed before that process can start?
Yes, this will still have a level of contaminant that we'll take out at the next step. So the material is going to now be fed down into the hopper on top of the compounder, where we'll add a master batch or any colourant to it as it falls down into the machine, into the barrel, onto the screws. It's then fed down the screws where the material goes from a solid state to a molten state.
So we've actually heated it up to make it now a liquid.
So yes, the material will pass down the barrel. This is an example of one we've got opened up. It'll pass down the screws over the flights of the screws and be pushed out at the end of the machine. It'll now come into contact with the filters and the die plate. So we've got a backing filter and a fine mesh screen, 120 micron.
So this is the front face of that die?
That's correct. And on the other side of the die, we'll have the filter plates, which will have the pancake behind it with the contaminants.
What sort of contaminants will I find in that pancake?
Anything non-PVC, basically. So it could be aluminium, steel, brass, copper, nylon, wood, stone. There's a whole multitude that we'll take out at this point.
So this is the die with the material being pushed through it slowed down. And what's happening now?
So there's a series of knives on the cutting head to give us our pellet.
So we're now ready to make PVC conduit then?
Not quite. We've got to cool the pellet down because it's still quite hot. So we'll run it through the cooler. We'll take out any oversized pellets and pass the good pellet through and up into the bag stand.
So what are you putting it into bags?
We're putting it into bags before the silo so we can just do some quality assurance checks. We'll run it through a small lab extruder where we'll produce a strip so we can look at surface finish. So we're looking for any inclusions or contaminant that might pass through. We can also cut the strip down and do a colour check on it to make sure that the material meets our standards.
So what you're trying to say there is you don't want to pollute the silos with something that would then enter the factory and find you've got a big error. So this process here means that we only send the good quality material in to make the conduits and drunkins.
That's correct. So let's remind ourselves what we had. On the left hand side is the feedstock that we started with, the recycled windows, and on the right hand side is the pellet that we're going to be putting into the silo.
So if we were to fill these three silos with those pellets, how many lengths of conduit could I make?
Well, those silos is enough capacity for 144 tonnes of material, which is enough material to make a quarter of a million lengths of 25 mil conduit. From the silos, the material is fed into the factory, into the extrusion machines where it comes into the hopper.
Is it now very similar to the compounding process we saw at the start of the video?
Yes, it is. We're going to take the material that's in a solid state in the pellet. We're going to feed it into the extruder, down the barrel and screws of the extruder where it's heated, melted, and then pushed through the die to form the shape of the conduit that we're trying to achieve.
Those pellets are now finally starting to look like conduit, but is it hot?
Yeah, it's 180 degrees as it leaves the die, so we've got to add vacuum and cooling to it to hold its shape, so we've got a solid product at the end of it that we can pass through the printers and the downstream equipment. The printers, we can add date code, time, any relevant standard markings, logo, web address, all that information we can add to it, and obviously the product itself.
We're seeing 25 millimeter conduit being made. Do you make any other sizes?
Yes, we make 20, 25 and 32 mil conduit in light gauge and heavy gauge, both high impact, mostly in white, but we also offer black.
The machine is cutting it into a 3 meter length. How many lengths would I get in a bundle?
30 lengths to a bundle, we'll be packing these ones.
I've had a little bit of a moment here. I'm thinking about this video and I'm thinking now, when I'm on site installing conduit, couldn't I turn around and say to the other trades on site, I'm actually also installing windows?
That's possible. They may laugh at you at this point, but you are actually using a product that's made from 80% plus recycled PVCU windows.
I like it. So on site now, I'm fitting windows.
You might have a challenge getting some glass into it, mind. The final stage of the process is now to pack the product. This is a manual operation on this line, but we do have lines that are automated, have their own packing cell on it. This will now be sleeved for protection, labels applied to identify the product, quantity, etc. It'll then be shipped off to our distribution centre on a stillage.
What a fascinating process that was to see PVC conduit being made. And as I move this pallet onto the truck, I can see mini trunking. And if you want to see how incredible that is to be made, check out the video on the screen now.